let's read Luke, the book of Luke.
Are you looking at Luke?
24. We'll read from verse 45.
Or to me, verse 45. Luke 24.
Verse 25. I'll read from Amplified Bible. I'll read from 45 going down.
Ketlobala 45 ke ya fas.
Then he opened their minds to help them understand the scriptures and said, and so it is written that the Christ, the Messiah, the anointed, will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance necessary for forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I was reading this scripture several times, and I want to share this scripture with you. The Bible talks about repentance. There is necessary repentance. If you can just read there, it says, especially verse 5, he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. So when Jesus went to the cross, the disciples were worried
and afraid.
Many of them were afraid of what will happen to them. So after he rose, many of them were not aware that he rose. So he began to appear to many disciples. Here, where we are reading, these are disciples who were going to a place called
Emmaus.
On the road, you know, they were still complaining, questioning why this thing has happened. And Jesus appeared to them, as you have read the scriptures. He began to question them. What are you talking about? Until he opened their minds. That's where we have read. He opened their understanding. I was learning there that unless our understanding is opened, we cannot reach the necessary repentance. Just write necessary repentance. Or repentance that is required. You know, there's a repentance that is needed, required, or necessary. If their minds were closed, look what they were saying on the road. Still complaining why Jesus suffer all this. But when their minds are open, they begin to feel warmth of his presence. And when he wanted to leave them, they say, no, we can feel he's leaving us. Stay with us. Because to be honest with you, repentance are differing. Here, the scripture says, their minds were open for necessary repentance. Why? Because Jesus suffered all this for that repentance. I was checking our repentance today. sometimes many of our repentance are questionable.
Di tsukulwa jarana chidingwe di abuchia di pujisho.
I mean, that is why Christians are still living like they are not even knowing Jesus.
Ona leba pulosa basa pilangle anajwalo kare Jesu azanga ba mutseive.
I want you to look at the scripture, especially on verse 47 there.
Kenya kora lebele butse butse kudu kudu mola ko verse 47.
Can you just read it in Pedi Mama?
Ariba lenka sepedi. Ore chabeng ka moka ka lena la gagwe go tseba tshwe tshokologo le go lebalelwa dibe wa tlothongwa ka Jerusalem.
Here it shows that repentance must be preached.
Mo o bona tswa gore tshokolo e tshwantse rerwa.
Repentance is the message that is needed.
For
us to understand his presence. For us to live with him. For us, for our life to be different with those who are not saved. If we read Matthew 3, verse 7 to 9.
Can you
just look at that verse there? Matthew 7. Matthew 3,
7 to 9.
Let me just read that verse for you. It says, but when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees coming to for baptism, he said to them, you brood of vipers.
Amen.
Who warned you to flee from the divine wrath and judgment to come? So produce fruit that is consistent with repentance. In other words, demonstrating new behavior that proves a change of heart and a conscious decision to turn away from sin. And okay, let's leave that verse that way. Yeah, if you can read here, you
will see,
John was looking on the Pharisees and Sadducees coming for baptism. He began to question, are they truly coming for repentance? Because when he looked at them, he knows that they were children of snakes. Say, brood of vipers. He said, who warned you to come for baptism? You know, everybody can still go for baptism, but that doesn't mean he has gotten repentance. Here, John was teaching that there's actions that we can take from the Bible. But that does not mean that you are necessary that you are saved.
Or
you got the message. The word that says, who warned you? It means they didn't hear the message. This man knew the message didn't reach them rightly. They were just doing it. Who warned you to repent so that you come for baptism? Who warned you to pray? Who warned you to do fasting? There are many things that we can do, but that does not mean that we got the message of repentance. Repentance message tells us that we need to hear and be convicted from the word. Somebody will preach the word. The message of faith will come. Faith comes by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. If you read there, you will see that in verse 8, he says, produce fruit. Produce fruit that is consistent with repentance. In other words, your behavior from now must show that you have gotten the repentance. If we read Matthew 9:10-13, is Jesus there called to repentance all who recognize their sins.
Jesu abicha baba lemo angur banali divi arabata basukulu.
Forgiveness.
Orabata baleba lelu divi.
He just called all and say, all of you, if we can recognize your sin.
Orale kalle moa sibi salina.
Come and repent.
Itlanghe lisukulu.
In Matthew 9:10-13.
Ola mu Mateo 9:10-13.
If you read Joel 2:12-13.
Arabala Joel 12.
I want us to read that verse there.
Joel 2.
Touch somebody and say, my friend.
Mokhotse.
Are you sure you have repented?
Onale nitimara ya uru sukulugile.
Are you a Christian?
Omopuluswana.
Look at this verse 12.
Arlebeleng verse 12.
Even now, says the Lord, turn and come to me with all your heart.
In other words,
this is a genuine repentance.
With
fasting, weeping, and mourning. Until every barrier is removed and the broken fellowship is restored.
Amen.
In other words, once you repent, you are being restored to his fellowship. Look at that verse again. It says, what? Turn to me, says the Lord. Can you just look at that verse? Just read aloud in your Bible.
It says, 12.
Even now, today, says the Lord, turn, come to me with all your heart. With all your heart. It means it's possible to turn to the Lord with a half heart or quarter heart.
He said,
have a genuine repentance. Understand that you mean it. Okay, look at that verse. It says, with fasting and weeping and mourning, until every barrier is removed and the broken fellowship is restored.
Here,
it shows that it's not just easy to say, I have repented. There's issue of crying here. Issue of mourning. You know why? The reason why people do wrong things
and
repent and go back to it is because of the way they repent. They didn't repent fully. If you repent fully, with fasting, you know, you don't have food in your stomach. You won't forget. You cannot suffocate yourself for nothing. You understand why you are going for that. With fasting and mourning, you cannot just cry knowing that you are going to do the same tomorrow. We are going to a point where we need to understand if we are Christians or not. We need to reach a level where we understand. Are we sure we are Christians? Or we are just bearing the name Christians? Joel, who prophesied about the coming of the Holy Spirit, is the one who's saying this. Listen, there are things that will never come from God until we have fellowship. And that fellowship, you get it from real repentance. Genuine repentance. I don't know if you're hearing me. Let me show you another scripture. If you remember Luke 18:10-14, you see the tax collector who went home being justified, forgiven of all the guilt, because he had a right standing with God. You could see a Pharisee, a Christian of that time, saying, I know myself, I understand my salvation, and I tithe all the time. Because many times when we are busy with our activities, we call that Christianity. Whereas fellowship must be established. Fellowship is needed. Look at this man who said, no, I cannot just even come closer to you, because I know I'm a sinner. But look at the different one who said,
tsai di fapane le tsaba bang.
I know how to operate in the house of God.
Tsaba shuma karangwa kwa ha umrena.
I know what I do.
Ebele ke ya tsebo re ke dira leng.
This might be telling us many things we think is Christianity, it might not be. Also, our character is checked.
And
how we approach God also. You know, many of us who think we are Christians, even the Bible warns us, be careful who are saying you are standing. You might be found that you are falling. So this man says, I know I took money of people in the wrong way. So I cannot approach God like
this,
my friend. Be merciful, I know my sin. I know I'm wrong. I can't even look unto you, God. You know, this scripture that Christians normally quote, that makes our Christianity so weak. 1 John 1:8-9. If you have done wrong, you can confess your sin. He's faithful and just, and forgive you your sin. You find that we end up doing it deliberately. Listen to this. God will forgive you if you know what you are doing. You were doing it not knowing. But repeating it before God knows that you don't care about the love he gave you. I don't know if you are hearing me. Can you just ask your neighbor, say, my friend, are you a genuine Christian? What about your repentance? If we read in the book of what? Matthew 26:75. You could see how Peter repented. When Peter found the truth. When Peter just found this truth. That Jesus was showing him that he remembered what he said.
Or Jesus.
Peter cried hysterically. Can you just look at that verse there? Matthew 26. Let's go there to 75. Just go there in your Bible. Read aloud in your Bible, verse 75.
You
say what in your version. Just stand up and read it.
Petro,
Peter remembered the weight of Jesus when he said, before the rooster crowed, you will deny me 3 times. Then he went outside and cried bitterly.
Amen.
I want to tell you what happened that day. Remember, Peter was boasting about his standing with God.
Petro na abo nchauri na
that's what we are normally doing. We boost ourselves as Christians. But we found that before God, we are not even there. And when things happen, we end up denying God. Many times when temptations come, and challenges come, we end up leaving God. When something happens, we end up just saying, we need to fight for ourselves. Here, you can hear Peter denying Jesus, bluntly, in a very simple way, because he didn't know what happened. He didn't know that he was called inside because he was recognized. I'll tell you what happened that day. When John was called, with the time Jesus was arrested, when John was inside there, he said, No. I left Peter there. He said, sorry, can you call that man there? to come close to Jesus.
Ora ta khauswe.
Because we were close. Let him come.
Ka ba ridula re le khauswe, abe khauswe le yena.
And what happened was when he was called.
Ha bi tswa yena.
He was thinking about if they arrest Jesus, they will also arrest me.
Ba tswere Jesus o le na le na ke tswero.
Whereas he was not called to be arrested.
Ka mona ya sabi le tshi taba ya o swarwa.
He was called to be a witness.
Ne ba mmetse ora ta abe paki.
He could not see what happened that side.
Na sa khone o bona ro dia nanga kwane.
He was called there to witness. But when he realized, he was afraid. And he denied three times. After he denied three times, it was over. He went back to his life. After Jesus
faced
all. But listen to this. When he denied the third time, what happened was this. Is where he was at the distance where Jesus could look at him. And you know what happened that day? He says, good, Jesus was facing down. And Peter is denying looking at Jesus. So now, when he denied the third time, what Jesus did was, he looked at him. So that's why he remembered.
Ah,
I fail on my assignment. I promise and I fail.
He went
outside and cried bitterly. You know, you have opportunity to be reminded so that you correct your ways. Tell your neighbor. You are given opportunity to be reminded so that you correct your ways. When you are still hearing the word of God, God is trying to remind you so that you fix yourself, not to condemn you. Our God does not condemn. He's reminding you. Can you see, fix this, fix that one until you stand your ground. I don't know if you're hearing me. So look here, this man cried bitterly when he remembered that. Why I allow this? I was supposed to be standing with him, but it was too late. I don't know if you're hearing me. Can I say this to you? When God gives you opportunity to repent, don't waste your time. I said, don't waste your time. Listen to this. Even Judas
Iscariot
was given chance to repent. But himself, he saw it necessary to kill himself. Nobody could do anything to Judas. Nobody could just kill Judas. He was on the center of going back and go to Jesus. So himself, he just took his life.
Tell
my friend, don't destroy yourself. You still have chance to go to Jesus. Don't destroy yourself. Repentance is necessary. As long as you are still hearing the message. Look at this verse also. In 2 Corinthians 7:10. Godly sorrow, that is from God, will always produce repentance.
Amen.
Without regret, leading to salvation. But worldly sorrow, the hopeless sorrow of those who do not believe, produces death.
Amen.
That's what happened to Judas. You see, here, godly sorrow, not worldly sorrow, godly sorrow produces repentance that will lead to salvation. So you can see that repentance and salvation is not one thing. Repentance and salvation is not one thing. Repentance is a door, salvation is a house. Repentance is a way in to salvation. So the moment when you have got godly sorrow, when you see that you have done wrong and confess your wrongs, Already you are going straight to your salvation.
Ora ro tsena he o tsena ka ra phuluso ya
hao. You can see this verse telling
Mora
us
khono bona verse
that truly God loves us here.
Ore ka nnete modimo re ratile.
If you read 2 Corinthians 3,
ba Korinta ba bo
11 to 18, I want us to read that verse.
11 to 18.
2 Corinthians.
Ba Korinta ba bobedi.
I'll tell you why I'm reading these verses for you.
Ke tole botsoro wa ke le balela mangwalwa.
Because many times
anchina
we are coming out of Christianity.
Re tswa ka ra phuluso.
We are talking about our salvation.
Re bolela ka phulusha rena.
And whereas our salvation doesn't have repentance.
Ka mo go phulusho ya gona ina is not sokolo.
Everybody when you say are you saved? But there's no repentance.
Man na kan ti sokolo a iyo.
Are you saved? Yes. Everybody is still here, but there's no repentance.
Motho ka o fela ka no re ke phulusho mara tsokolo e se teng.
Repentance is when you get that godly fear.
Tsukuluo ke he wena o thotse poifo yela ya bomodimo.
And now you see your wrongs.
Wa bona di phosho tsa
gago. You need to confess them to God.
O talk out di bulela o ba o ipolela morene.
After you do that,
kamara ga o dia se.
You have entered a journey of salvation.
O tsene ka ra lieto la phuluso.
Salvation you work it out every day.
Phuluso wena o ya ishuma tsa ka lichache.
Salvation is a journey.
Phuluso ke lieto.
Can you tell anybody, my friend?
Bo jam tholeng ga from God.
Repentance is your way to salvation.
Ke tsukuluwa ke tsela ya gao ya o ya phuluso.
People are talking about we are saved.
Ba
bo tswa
bo lela ba ra phuluso re se phuluso.
But your lifestyle is not showing.
Mara mogwa o phela o bontshe re go na le phuluso.
If you are saved,
a bo lela o phulusitswe.
Let's see it with your lifestyle.
Are re boneng ka mogwa wa bophelo.
Let's see your character.
Are re bone mogwa wa hao wa o phela.
If your character is questionable, somewhere you are talking salvation without repentance.
Ba bo lela phuluso ya ntse o sna tsukulu.
I don't know if you hearing me.
A ke tsaba lento.
We need to check our lives.
Re tsoka thokala maphelo a rena.
You know, not long I was learning something that
e se khale ke thutile se sengore.
Which I've concluded but I want to tell you.
Se ke se felele di cheng mara re ke le thalosetseng.
You know, when you are growing.
A hola.
Growing.
O hola.
You have many dreams.
Bona le ditoro jetingata.
But there's a dream that we don't even think about.
Mara bona le toro engwa ona hane ka yona.
Is death.
Ke re ya khoiwa khoiwa.
We don't even think about
are yewe yona are nya ko botsana u yona.
Many of us we are caught in our plans.
Ba banje ri tswarwa ri le ka ra di plan tsa rena.
When we are still thinking we are going to do this and we finish.
Re sa nna go di asera nya malala.
You know repentance.
Wa bona tsukulo.
Is a preparation of your life to come.
A bo phelo bo bo satao.
If you deal with repentance.
A u shumana le tsukulo.
You are declaring that there's a life that is coming.
O bolela re ona le bo phelo bo bo saleng tseleng.
But when you don't care about repentance,
mara ha o sna taba ka tsukuluo,
as if you are saying you are here forever.
O tshwana le wena o rena ke mo lefaseng ke phela o ya go
ile. This world is not our home.
Ene lefase la se ha.
Tell me about this world is not your home.
O tshwana ka ofe mo a se ga ye ngwana eshu.
I mean, take care of your salvation.
Wena tokomela phuluso ya hao.
Deal with yourself.
Shumana le bo wena.
Check your life.
Lekola bo phelo ba hao.
What will happen in the last day?
O tla tlhola lang matsatsing a bofelo.
When you find you were coming to church.
A wena o tlhola re ke go nna le wi ya o tswere
dancing in the church whatever.
E le wi na o dia mitholo e ka ofela.
You find that you are not worthy to enter.
Mara ba tlhola ra wa swanela ka o tsena le go thimo.
Repentance is needed.
Sokologo ye ya nyakeya.
In fact, I was even thinking alone and say
botse botsene ke nana ke le tikere
is better we preach repentance all over the world.
Ka one re sukulu re bolele ka tshukulu we mithayo yothe
because there's too much many things
ka bana dilona lona di search di teji
that raises questions
che di tradition di yang uri di putisho di thae
especially in our characters
kudukudu mihweng ya rena
especially when we say we are children
kudukudu ari picha bana ba modimo
sometimes we are not even different with the world
na go tshedi ngwa ri fa pane le ba le ba ke le faseng
even the language we talk is the language of the world
le dipolelo tse re di bolelang re bolela dipolelo tsa le fasile.
Think about Christians
who
are still doing what the world can do.
Baba sadirang di ntotsa go dirwa ke batho ba lefase.
They are lacking repentance.
Ba ithuta ka tshukuluo.
You know repentance bring fear.
Tshukuluo e tisa poifo.
And you correct yourself before you are corrected.
Wa te pushula motho mo a so botse gore o di
ase.
Ke mo tshukuluo e thomang teng.
It brings fear.
E tisa poifo.
Of God.
Ya o boifo
motho. So that you correct yourself before someone judges you.
Pele motho mo a ta wa thula.
I don't know if you are hearing me.
Ke se valento.
Can you tell anybody say my friend?
Wo cha mtole ga from khotsi.
Repentance
tsukuluwe
brings a light on you.
It is a siecha
wena. So that you check yourself.
Utlela uri wena go ti tholishisha.
Before someone check you.
Pele motho mangwa ta u thola.
You know, let me try to give example.
Re ke le feng montana.
You can still hide your sin.
Okano fitas
today, tomorrow,
le khono ka usane,
next week,
le beke tangwa fita.
But one day it will be exposed.
Mara tashile ti fela ditatjela pepe neneng.
You can still hide.
Kano ipitla.
Your sin.
Wa fitla divi.
But one day it will bring punishment.
Tashile lingwe ditotisa kotlo.
What God wants is a fellowship with you. Relationship with you. I don't know if you're hearing that. I mean, we need to bring back that fellowship where we can hear from God, where we can live right and have fear
or
do what is wrong. I don't know if you're hearing me. I say, my friend, are you sure you're a Christian? Look at that person's eyes. Look at the person's eyes. You will see repentance is lacking. Repentance is lacking. Repentance is like
short up to
we are talking about things in the house when we are outside. When repentance enters you, you enter, you experience it. Listen to this. Even if you are quiet, you are preaching. If you are saved, let me say it again. Even when you are quiet, you are preaching. If you are saved, it's when you deal with yourself. If you have repented and you are dealing with your life, even when you are quiet, you are preaching. So you don't need to shout so that people will understand. Even when you deal with yourself and stand your grounds, because you want relationship with him. Once you get that relationship, he comes to be with you. I don't know if you're hearing me. I say he's coming to you in the name of Jesus. I say he's coming to you in the name of Jesus. These are the last days that we must deal with our repentance. Deal with our repentance. I can give an example that I'm saved and I'm dealing with my repentance. And whatever I'm doing here, I'm doing it because God wanted me to do it. So look here. If I do the opposite, you will know. You will really know. People are looking at you, checking if truly you are Christian. Don't compromise that step. You have got many spectators around. They can still judge you that you are wrong. But do what is right. Live your life. Carry on with your life. They can still say you are not a Christian. They speak whatever. Remember Matthew 5 verse 11. Blessed are you when they say all kinds of things. They will try to persecute you because of him. Why? Because he's there. The moment when he's there, people will try to persecute you. Don't lose that salvation. Deal with your repentance until to the end. If you believe, shout hallelujah. That's what I've been doing. I check that, okay, I must deal with my salvation. Deal with my salvation. This week I was telling myself that in these 2 days I was having Monday or Tuesday. Let me look at myself. When everybody's looking at me, let me also look at myself. Because many people look on others, they fail to look at themselves. Because, you know, repentance helps us to look at ourselves. So when people are saying what they are saying, you are able to repent and follow him. If you are sinning, or you are carrying on with the fellowship you have before God, I don't know if you are hearing me. Ask your neighbor, say, my friend, are you sure you are Christian? Are you sure you are Christian? Are you sure you are Christian? And the difficult times is coming. I want to tell you that there's going to be many plots against you so that you sin. That's why I'm talking about repentance. That's The difficult time is coming.
Na kwe wei ma yeta.
That many people will lie against you.
Batu ba ncha batu bache batokulela makakalena.
That okay, you are doing this, you are doing that.
Odi yase, odi yase, odi yase.
Others will create stories.
Baba ngoba tota kadita bache di singhona.
That will produce as if you are doing that.
Kere tajwele changdilo kare we na unkile wa di di.
I'm referring to you as a Christian.
Kewele lali na jolo kamo puluso.
So deal with your repentance.
Shumana le puluso ya hao.
Especially when you are in charis.
Eh, kudu kudu hao le charisi.
Difficult times are coming.
Dina gochebu kitidi eta.
You know, I was told by my father in the Lord saying.
Ke leka bo chakan tata kamurene ngbare.
Be careful of scandals.
Tokomela di ntochebare kidi
scandals. I'm also telling you the same.
Imele na kibo chale na hape.
Be careful.
Tokomela.
You don't need to have a scandal.
Awo toko ubale di tabachi.
You don't need to have what a scandal.
Awa swanelo ubale di lochebu
lwa. Difficult times are coming.
O bale na gochebu kitidi eta.
People will trap you.
Batu bato utanya.
People will try many things.
Batu bato leka ntochedinga.
But listen. Maintain that repentance. Maintain that salvation. And God will judge them. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Listen. A person who knows that repentance is painful. He won't play with sin. You know, repentance, the process of repentance is painful. You won't entertain sin. Because going back from the beginning is painful. Breaking that wall of separation is painful. Thinking about what you have lost also is painful. So what you will do, you can rather do what Joseph did. You can rather leave your coat and run away. We need Christians like that. This year,
wow.
I see you living a Christian life. I see you as a Christian who will be example in the name of
Jesus.
I see you as a Christian who's more than a conqueror in the name of
Jesus.
Repentance is required. Necessary to bring a change in your life. Where you can look at yourself and you find you are living right life. And there are Christians here today. God is raising you today to be example to those sinners. You will bring them back to the Lord. If you believe, shout hallelujah. You know, I found this, that when you get that repentance, you know, you won't allow anything to disturb your salvation again. I can give an example of repentance I'm talking about. There is fasting. There is crying. There is thinking why you did this, why you failed. There's issues of thinking too much before you confess and say, I have done wrong. Why do you allow that to happen?
Why you do melanto ideala?
All those issues of judgments that will be coming to you because of the Holy Spirit. You don't need that. You don't need that. Listen, if your conscience is revived, you won't live a life that will hurt Holy Spirit. Can I say it again to you? If your conscience is revived, you'll care about your actions because you'll be afraid it will hurt Holy Spirit. Always, before that, you just know, I'm hearing this, I can't do this. If I do this, what will happen? I say repentance is required. How many of you want to repent today? If you want to repent today, I can tell you this. Don't go back to the same thing you were doing. The blood of Jesus is a soap that cleans sins away. We must not waste the blood of Jesus. We must not waste the blood of Jesus. Don't waste the blood of Jesus.